So in our last video, we saw how to fetch normal configurations like input path, output path from the config file. Now, what if you want to fetch entire struct type schema or complex values from the config file? So in this video, we'll see a normal requirement. We have to define a struct type schema, how to avoid hard coding it inside the code, and how to fetch it from the config file. So for this, let's create a normal string for all these values and create a config for this. Let me copy all this and just take the values. Let's create some identifiable delimiters. So our column name and the data type will be space separated, and all the columns along with their data types will be comma separated. And we can remove all the trues, because this anyways we can generate. This is a same value for all. And just take all these values separated by the comma. Now let's go to our config file as I have created in my last tutorial, and create a new section because this doesn't have path. This is a schema, and let's say landing file schema is this. So how we have this is column name and the type. So perfect. Let me comment this out. I don't need this now. So now my landing file schema can be config.get. Here we want schema, which is our section, and the value is landing file schema. And this has to be inside the quotes. Now, do you think that directly passing this landing file schema here will generate our schema? No, because this is a normal string and we have to create respective objects for this. So this is a bit complex, and to simplify it, let us not mess up this code. Let's create a new module itself, which we'll import, and we'll create a function in that will parse our schema. So let me create a normal function file. It will be a Python file, and let's call it gk functions. No need for .py, it will automatically take it. And this will have our all necessary functions. Now let's define a method. Let's say read schema, and this can accept this string that we are fetching as an config. So particularly this string, this is will come as a string, and this it should accept. So let's say schema arguments. Now what we have to do? First, we have to split that string with commas. So to split the values, let's create a split values, and simply whatever schema arg that we are getting, we have to split using the dot split function, and we have to split it with comma. Fine. Now to create schema out of those, first let's create a blank schema. Let's say SCH is struct type, and it won't import. So for that we have to import from PySpark SQL types import struct type. So this will be our blank schema. Now for each value inside this, whatever split values are coming, for each we'll do a loop on this for I in split values. For each value, what we have to do, again for each value, we have suppose this is one value. Again, for each value we have to split it with a space. So for this we can do x equals I dot split. I will be the first value inside, that means a column and the data type, that will be I. So I dot split, that is separated by space. And in this particular schema we can just add the values that we have got after splitting with space. That means in schema, first argument is the column name, second argument will be the data type, third argument has to be true. So let's see how to go ahead with that. So SCH, that is our blank schema, dot add. Now first argument will be the column name, which will come as first value of x, so x0. Second will be x of 1, third will be nullable or not nullable, that is true. But thing to notice here is, this is x1 will be the splitted value of string type. That means this will be a string, not an actual string type object. So we have to read this as a string and infer that it is an string type object. So that this is one important thing to notice. So to read that, we can define a normal Python dictionary. So let's say D types, and normal dictionary can be initiated as curly bracket and this. Now this will give whatever value we pass into the dictionary. If that value exists as a key, it returns a value. So similar way we have to configure it, as in case it gets string type as a string, in that case it should return string type, and again it should be imported. But anyways, now we can remove all this from our main Python file, because we are not going to use all these SQL types in this particular file. So we can remove it and import it inside our functions. So now we have all string type. The next value would be for integer type, and we also have our timestamp type in our schema. Let's say we also have double type, and similar strings we are going to pass here. So string type as a string will return the string type object, integer type, timestamp type and double type. Remove the comma from the last, and in place of second passing directly as a string, you can pass this inside D types, and after the for loop we can return the schema. So let's call this function in our other Python file and see if this works. We have already read the schema from the file, but this is not the actual schema. So let's say let's call it landing file schema from conf, and the actual landing file schema will be read schema of this string. Now interesting part, how does it read the read schema? This is in another file. So in Python, to import some other file as a module, you can import it from using the from keyword from the location of your package. So location of my package is src main Python. Inside my Python I have a gk functions, from that I have to import the read schema. Now the error is gone. So you can see now, even if I remove this, my code looks much prettier, and all the files, all the schema, all the input output paths are being read from the config file. So let's see, are we able to read the file now as well? Yes, we are. So thank you guys for watching this video. I hope you liked it. Please, if you really did, please subscribe to my channel and stay tuned to GK Code Labs.